I want to talk to you about one of the doctrines of salvation that fascinates me the most, regeneration. It is the infusion of the divine nature of God that brings a renewed spiritual life, which is confirmed by a good spiritual fruit. When God formed Adam from the dust of the earth, he breathed life upon him. And he said to Adam that if he would eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, he would surely die. Well, we all know how does the story end. Adam ate from that fruit, and as a consequence, he died, and not only him, but all the generations after him. Ephesians 2:1 teaches us that our crimes of sin keep us bound to death. Have you ever heard people saying, "Oh, I feel empty"? Well, this is just a symptom of their dead in spiritual death. Someone who is dead spiritually doesn't desire to walk in light or righteousness. Rather, the contrary, they practice sin because they cannot overcome their flesh. Imagine asking a tiger to become a vegetarian. That's impossible. It's part of their nature to eat meat. I met men and women that they practice infidelity, and some of them know it's wrong, and they know it destroys their family. And I've talked to some of these men, and they tell me, "Yeah, I know it's wrong, but I cannot stop being unfaithful to my wife because it's part of my nature." And they're right. It's part of their sinful nature, and they cannot do anything to change it. I want to read you a scripture where Christ teaches us about this. In Matthew 7:17-20, it says, "Likewise, every good tree bears good fruit, but a bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Thus, by their fruit you will recognize them. The consequence of spiritual death here on earth is eternal death in hell. God judges us for all the sins that we have committed against him. Christ said that a bad tree would be cut down and thrown into the fire. That's terrible news, because we cannot change our sinful nature, and that sinful nature condemns us into eternal shame, pain. This is what Jesus tried to explain to Nicodemus when he told him that it is necessary to be born again in order to see the kingdom of God. Within ourselves, we cannot be born again. We don't have that ability. We need the Spirit to do it. Someone who is dead cannot provide life to himself. There are many people that believe that they are justified through their good works or through religion, but this is not enough. Paul said that our works of righteousness do not save us. No good thing that we do can change our sinful heart. Then, is there any power that can change our corrupt nature? Is there anything that can change our desire to lust, steal, lie into pure and holy desires? No amount of knowledge can do that, because our problem, it's not here, but it's in our hearts. We do not have the power to change it. It's something that has to come from the inner part of us. When Christ died on the cross and resurrected, he demonstrated that he had power over sin and death. He destroyed the power that death had over you, and he is the only one that can give you a new nature through his Spirit. It is only through Jesus that we can receive a new heart. How does this happen? How are we regenerated? Well, the Bible teaches us that it's only through genuine repentance to God and when we put our total trust in Jesus Christ. This means that we have to abandon the idea that there is anything good in us that can save us. We don't have the ability to change ourselves. You have to put all your trust in the amazing miracle of the cross. I would like to read a scripture out of Hosea 13:14. It explains what Christ accomplished on the cross. It says, "I will ransom them from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. Where, O death, are your plagues? Where, O grave, is your destruction?" It is only through Jesus' death on the cross that we can pass from death to life. It is very important that you understand that Jesus doesn't want to fill your emptiness or void in your heart. Instead, he wants to change your whole nature. He wants to create something new inside of you. If you want to see the kingdom of God, you need to be born again. Regeneration happens from the inside out. I remember when I experienced this deep change in my life. I was out of town in a youth retreat, and in one moment, I started feeling deeply convicted of my sin. I knew I was disobeying God. I knew I was going to hell. The first thing I did, I just went into the floor and started crying out for mercy. I was laying on the ground for about an hour, just pouring out my heart to Jesus, asking him to forgive me. When I stood up from the ground, I knew something was different in me. Literally, I would look up to the sky and the color of the sky was bluer. It's like my senses were more aware. Something external was showing a change that happened inside of me, that God produced in me. I want to give you an example to make it even more clear. Imagine a man that has been addicted for many years either to sex or money or drugs, and then he has a radical encounter with Jesus that enables him to break this addiction. But a few months later after his conversion, an old friend comes and offers him free drugs, the best drugs you can find for free, or the woman of his dreams just comes and wants to sleep with him. Or maybe a person he knows offers him easy money by doing something illegal. If this man would have not experienced regeneration, he would have no chance to say no to those things. But when you experience regeneration, it enables you to say no to sin. It gives you the power to step over the temptation that Satan brings to you. Paul explains it this way in 2 Corinthians 5:17. It says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here." Someone who has experienced regeneration will produce fruit that confirms it. If you have been regenerated, you cannot see sin the same way you did before. Something that gave you pleasure and that you would do as a hobby, now it gives you shame, and you know you're disobeying God. You were used to it, but now it's something you don't want to do because your desires have changed inside. Jesus wants to do that work in you through his Spirit. If you know that you need to be born again, just cry out for mercy to Jesus. Remember that you cannot do it by yourself. You need the supernatural happening into your life. Please do just like I did. Go into the ground and cry out Jesus to forgive you, and you will experience a new birth.